We're going to watch Tony hit some balls here and see where he is on his progress. Elbow drills first, and then we're going to hit some shots. I'm not going to say a whole lot here the first couple minutes. I just want to watch and see what you're doing.
Okay.
And how about you talk me through what you're thinking about as you're making these elbow drills?
Okay, sounds good. Well, my initial approach, still working on just getting a little bit of knee flex. Like I said in the last lesson, I was getting too much knee bend, so now just getting a little knee flex. And then that's step one. Step one to two, I'm really thinking about not dropping my head, keeping my head at an even steady level. So that's this one here. Also keeping my left toe down, my left big toe down. And then step two to three is really what you mentioned in the last lesson, really working on pretty hard. So trying to get my hip out in front of me so that I'm not trying to move my upper body. So it's a little bit slower than how I was doing the elbow drill, but it's still something that I'm still trying to think through.
Okay, one more here.
Okay.
All right, go ahead and go back. Okay. Look down toward the ball. There you go. Okay, let's go ahead and hit some shots here.
Okay.
Don't put a whole lot of thought into it. I just want you to stand up there, and we're just going to make some mini swings, quarter swings as we call them. Don't put a whole lot of thought into it. I don't want you grinding on this. I just want to see what you're doing. Okay. Make one or two practice swings, and then step up and hit it. Okay, one or two practice swings, put some thought into it, and then stand up there and just hit it. There you go. There you go. Okay, good. There you go. Good. There you go. All right. Okay, good. One more. Okay. Now, Tony, I want you to step up to this ball. No thought. All right?
Okay.
Don't just swing.
Okay.
Okay? Say not a full swing, but just swing. Don't put any thought into it. Let it happen. There you go.
Mm-hmm.
All right. I like what you're doing, okay? You're really putting a lot of thought into it.
Yeah.
And it's easier said than done for me to just say stand up and hit it.
Yeah.
You know, here you are, the past, you know, month and a half, you've really been grinding on this, you know, it's like a puzzle here, okay?
Sure.
And now I've got a ball in front of you, and I'm asking you to make some swings. and to really not think about it. Okay?
Mm.
That's the progression that we'll make from now on. Okay. We'll take what you've been doing in the elbow drill, refine and perfect that, and then incorporate it into a motion.
Okay.
Where you can repeat that motion and repeat it, you know, without putting much thought into it. Because you're to the point now where you need to start working on that a little bit.
Yeah.
Okay? You were thinking so intensely about those balls that you were hitting, you can see how it paralyzes you.
Yeah.
Well, this is exactly what we don't want come May and June.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? This is exactly what would have happened back in October.
Sure.
If I would have made some significant changes to your swing, you would have been paralyzed.
Yeah.
You wouldn't have been able to perform, and those lessons really would have been a waste of your time and would have been a waste of money too. So
mm-hmm.
This is really the time of year to dig down, do some of the major surgery that needs to be done where it's not so painful.
Yeah.
You know, it's, I'm not going to say it's easy.
Sure.
But you certainly couldn't go outside and perform on the golf course with any sort of proficiency working on what we're working on.
Yep.
Okay? So this is clearly the value of being able to come indoors in the wintertime without any expectations to get some of the work done that we really need to get done in a controlled environment.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So from now on, I want to see you incorporating that ball.
Yep.
Okay?
Okay.
I don't want to see you hit it great. That's not what we're here for, but it's so that when you do go outside, you all of a sudden don't lock up over the ball.
Yep.
And revert back to, okay, now thinking about it. So there's a progression from really intensely thinking about what needs to take place and change,
mm-hmm.
and then speeding that up a little bit so that that ball, you're not so intimidated.
Okay.
Ball's just there.
Yep.
Okay? Now let's talk about some of the things that you're doing that I really like. Go ahead and turn sideways, face me. Set up like you're going to make a swing. Okay. I really like how your knee flex has changed, okay?
Mm-hmm.
I really like how you're bending from your hips. I really like your posture. Your back is nice and flat. That's really good. Now go ahead and turn and face the camera. The width of your stance is much, much better, okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right? As you shift back into your right, go ahead and just shift back into your right. Go ahead and shift back into your left.
Okay.
I like the separation here, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You've got good separation there. You've created this motion right here with your back. You've heard the term backswing before.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what starts the backswing? Your phone?
Yeah.
No, your back. Use your back. That's what starts your backswing, okay?
Yep.
You didn't snatch that club up with your hands like you had in the past.
Mm-hmm.
So you've shifted into your left hip. You've got that big toe on your left foot is down on the ground, okay? That's a perfect position right there. Now, from there, just shift to your right and go through. Notice how that club brushed that mat.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't tell Tony to brush the mat with your club. I just said shift your weight to your right and let the club come through.
Mm-hmm.
Almost every practice swing that you've made today, that club is consistently brushing the mat.
Yep.
How many times did that club touch the ground when we first went out there and you hit those golf balls?
Not often.
It didn't touch the ground.
Yeah.
Okay? So I'm not telling Tony to hit down on the ball. I'm not telling Tony to hit the mat. I'm telling Tony to do certain things with his body, and the result of that is that club is consistently brushing the ground right now.
Mm-hmm.
It's because that club is being pulled through rather than you pushing it through.
Yep.
Your sequence of motion is much better, the sequential motion that you're creating with your body. It's putting that club in a position where it is going to strike that ball. Okay? It's
mm-hmm.
not going to be moving up. It's not going to be going over the top of the ball. So, you know, I'm really pleased that I'm seeing some of these things that are a result of what you're doing in a positive fashion.
Sure.
Okay? That club brushing that ground almost every time. That's really good.
Mm-hmm.
It's what you want.
Yep.
Okay? All right. So we're going to improve that elbow drill even a little bit more today. So go ahead and take that club, put it behind your back. That last elbow drill you made probably felt a little foreign to you.
Yep.
All right. Just pushing the envelope here a little bit more. Take this club, point it slightly at or behind the ball, and you do that by using your back. There you go. Now that's a stretch right there, isn't it?
It is.
Okay. You've got your back engaged here. You've got your hips, your hips have released, and that's good, but your hips haven't over-rotated. You've got good spacing between your knees right there. That's excellent right there. That's going to give you a good wide arc. That club's going to be traveling a great distance. You can feel all of this rubber band here is really tight.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? You've got a lot of energy there right now.
Yep.
Now, shift that right hip to your right. Keep shifting it. Shift it. There you go. Hold that there. That energy is all being released right now.
Yep.
Now from here, I want you to focus in on this. I'm going to get my hand under your hip right here.
Okay.
Pull this hip around. Boom.
Okay.
That hip stays in front of your chest.
Okay.
Okay? Notice how you're straight over your right leg here. Mm-hmm. You're not like this. Your shoulders aren't out here and your hips are back underneath you.
Yep.
Do that again.
Okay.
So we're increasing our range of motion going back, aren't we?
We are.
But increasing that range of motion, it has not deteriorated. Don't let your chin duck down so much. There you go. All right, come on through. Come on through. Hold that there. That's impact or slightly post-impact. Now I want the hips to keep moving. There you go. The hips move the shoulders.
Okay.
The shoulders follow the motion that the hips have made. The shoulders do not overpower this move. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
You might have heard of coming over the top. You know, that's what can happen. Okay?
Yeah.
You throw that shoulder out. That club gets out of orbit over here and some bad things can happen. So your hips initiate position 2 to 3.
Okay.
They also finish it. They are the leaders. The hips create that motion and everything else follows. The chain reaction is the things are following. Mm-hmm. The shoulders don't create that motion.
Okay.
Let's do this again. Don't let the chin lower as you go back. That's one. Two, hold that there. Get that big toe of your left foot on the ground. You feel it tighten just a little bit more?
Yep.
Okay, 2 to 3. Feel that hip really lead. Hold that right there. Okay, and then 3 to 4, keep those hips moving. There you go. Now, that's it. That's the motion.
Mm-hmm.
And what we need to do is we need to perfect that so that you don't have to think about it and you can move at a much more rapid speed.
Okay.
If you can do that and we can get you to hold on to the club, you will hit the ball.
Okay.
Okay.
Sounds good.
All right. Do that again. Now get that big toe on the ground. There you go. Keep the hips moving. There you go. Now, subtle. It's really subtle, but you'll be able to see it on video. You'll be able to see how your hips have initiated that move and they stay out in front,
mm-hmm.
Okay? Your upper body is more passive. That is the proper kinetic chain that you want.
Yeah.
Okay? So, we've taken that elbow drill from a really crude position a month and a half ago, and you're doing this elbow drill pretty religiously, mm-hmm. although you had to take about 3 weeks off,
yep.
But you haven't deteriorated. Okay, which is mm-hmm. good, because we don't want that to take place, and that's
sure.
why we move at the speed that we can move at. You know, if you can put more time into it and you can work on it, we move faster. If you can only allocate yourself a certain amount of time a week, which, you know, most people are working, they don't have unlimited time.
Sure.
You just move at the pace that you can move. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I would say today your elbow drill is really now your elbow drill.
Yeah.
And you can work on this elbow drill as much as you want without the fear of going backwards.
Mm-hmm.
The more you work on it, the better you're going to be.
Okay.
That's just all, or the faster that you're going to, you know, soak this in and get acclimated to this. So
mm-hmm.
You now are moving at the speed that you can move at.
Okay.
Okay. You don't need me there every 3 days to look over this elbow drill and grade you.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not that we won't improve it and refine it, but the overall motion, 1, 2, 3, and 4, is in place.
Mm.
The positions are good. The sequence is good. Okay, let's go ahead now. Make some swings. The first couple swings, you put in a little thought into it, or I should say the first swing. Second swing, just kind of blend it in a little bit. Don't put so much thought. Third swing, just swing.
Okay.
There you go. Good. So the first couple swings, you're putting a little thought into it. And then the third one, you just stand up there and you hit it. Whatever happens, happens. There you go. I really like that. There you go. There you go. There you go. Great. Tony, do you have any questions, any comments?
No questions, but obviously, as we continue to refine the elbow drill, things feel a little funny. But like you said, each time you show me something, I work on it pretty diligently. And as far as I think, I mean, it's starting to feel more natural, more normal. And then every time you add a new wrinkle, it feels funny for a while, and then it starts to feel better. I mean, just watching my videos with my lessons, it looks like things are starting to change for the better, and I think that's the whole point of this, so I like where it's going.
Yeah, you've made some sincere changes. Mm-hmm. It's hard for me as a teacher to say, okay, you're at position A, B, or C or in your development, because your potential's unlimited. But mm-hmm. You've made some sincere changes that we could have never made outside. That's what's so important about this. If you would have insisted that we do something outside and try to get good, if you'd have come to me in June, it would have been a disaster, mm-hmm. Okay? You've made some sincere changes, and I'm confident that when you come out in the spring, you're going to be, you know, very pleased at the results. Mm-hmm. But it's still up to you.
Right.
I can only give you the information. You need to work on it. Mm-hmm. So I'd like to see you work on it a little bit more if you can.
Yep.
Okay. And that doesn't mean 10 hours a week. That just means, you know, if you can do it, the elbow drill, 2 or 3 times a day for 5 or 10 minutes at a clip. Mm-hmm. You're going to get something out of it.
Sure.
You know, now the more time you spend on it, the more you're going to get out of it. Mm-hmm. So to summarize what we've done today, what are you thinking about that you needed to do from today's lesson? What did we refine?
First of all, just from the last lesson into this one, when I go to my backswing, keeping my head up or at a steady level.
Right.
And then from step 1 to 2 of the elbow drill. Step 2 to 3, really letting my hips initiate all of the action. And then from 3 to 4, keeping my hips moving when I'm doing that. And then when I'm hitting the golf ball, I shouldn't really be thinking all too much when I'm actually hitting the golf ball, just because that's, I'm thinking about it so much that it's kind of, like you said, it's not a setback, but it's just kind of, I'm thinking too much and things aren't quite as fluid as they could be. So that's something when I am hitting balls, maybe my first couple swings, think about how it's going to go, and then my third one stepping up, I'm just kind of trying to let it be a fluid motion as we work toward the spring.
Okay. So, and I'll summarize as well. Keeping the big toe on your left foot down.
Yep.
We've increased your range of motion going back. Okay. So we've got that club moving from, you know, your front foot to the middle or slightly behind the ball. Mm-hmm. So you've increased that rotation there, okay? Then we've initiated those hips going out and through and staying out and through, mm-hmm. staying in front of you, okay? So I think we're on the same page. I like the progress. I like the fact that you're hitting the ball now, but this is not by any stretch finals week.
Right.
This is just one more step in the process. I don't want you to place any emphasis on the quality of ball that you hit into the net. You know, some will be better than others, but that's not why we're hitting the ball. We're hitting the ball so that it becomes part of the routine, mm-hmm. okay? And that's important. So I like the progress, and I see things moving forward pretty good. I look forward to it. I'm encouraged.
Yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to it too. I'm excited.
All right, well, stay tuned and keep checking on Tony's progress. He's going to go out there and kill it this summer.